As the original trilogy showed clearly, Obi-Wan, as well as Yoda, were certain that once Anakin Skywalker had fallen to the dark side, it would be impossible for him to be redeemed back into the light, with the dark side having consumed and destroyed the individual they knew as Anakin. In a recent video, we looked at why Obi-Wan believed this. Writing a few years after Order 66, Obi-Wan recognized that once he confronted Darth Vader on Mustafar, he sensed nothing but pure evil within him, with the light of Anakin extinguished. Even compared to Dooku's dark side acolyte, Asajj Ventress, Vader was in a different category. As a Sith, he was consumed by fury and fear, and thus, he would forever be trapped upon the path of the dark side. Of course, we know that both Obi-Wan and Yoda were wrong. Vader was redeemed by his son Luke. And thanks to the Legends novel, The Life and Legend of Obi-Wan Kenobi, we get to see the reaction and thoughts of Obi-Wan when he witnessed his former apprentice kill Darth Sidious and be redeemed back into the light. As we'll see, the great aspect here is that his reaction goes far past mere astonishment. While it wouldn't match the transformation of Vader, it definitely approached it, with Obi-Wan himself going through a significant stage of development. Although in Episode 6, we see the final discussion between Luke and the Force Ghost of Obi-Wan occur on Dagobah following the death of Yoda, the Life and Legend of Obi-Wan Kenobi novel shows that Obi-Wan didn't leave Luke's presence once he entered the Endor system. Obi-Wan would eventually watch as Luke turned himself over to Darth Vader, and as Luke would fail to turn the Sith Lord back towards the light then and there, Obi-Wan was filled with regret that he didn't do more to convince Luke that his father was gone. As Luke went before the Emperor and ultimately engaged Vader in lightsaber combat, Obi-Wan was actually urging Luke to kill Vader, sensing that Luke was being consumed by too much fear for his friends, and therefore, approaching the dark side. Ultimately, as Luke emerged victorious and with Sidious prompting Luke to take his father's place within the Sith Order, Obi-Wan was certain that all was lost even though Luke had just refused the Emperor's request. Completely convinced that Vader's nature was now defined by the dark side, the Jedi Master believed Vader would simply continue to act as Sidious's apprentice while Luke was killed. However, as Luke was being devastated by Sidious's Force Lightning, Obi-Wan couldn't help but keep his eyes on his former friend and apprentice. He was completely stunned as he watched Vader lift the Emperor off the ground, carry him across the throne room, and then throw him down the Death Star's elevator shaft, collapsing as Luke went to his side. As we mentioned previously, Obi-Wan couldn't believe what happened, recognizing that had he not seen the event take place before him, he would have never believed it. He was so certain that Anakin had been consumed by the flames of Mustafar, pure evil that was no more than anger, hatred, and fury. As he watched Luke embrace the redeemed Anakin Skywalker, Obi-Wan realized exactly the extent of his own failure. Whereas Luke, and even Padme, had always believed there was still good within Vader, by refusing to allow for the possibility that Anakin wasn't completely gone, Obi-Wan condemned his former friend to be trapped by the dark side. And by refusing to allow for the emergence of hope regarding Vader's redemption, he failed to find that an unwavering faith in the innate goodness of Vader was far more powerful than the pull of the dark side, a truth that he had to be shown by Luke. Even more, Obi-Wan remembered an early lesson that the spirit of his master Qui-Gon tried to teach him during his exile on Tatooine. Obi-Wan had just learned the truth about Anakin's actions in murdering an entire camp of Tusken Raiders, seen in Attack of the Clones. Angered that Qui-Gon never told him this, particularly when it became clear that Anakin had revealed this truth to Padme, Palpatine, and even the Jedi Knight Aes-Sedai Het, Qui-Gon simply told Obi-Wan the secret was kept from him because he wasn't ready. Following Anakin's redemption, Obi-Wan finally understood the lesson. He wasn't ready to forgive Anakin. Just as he wouldn't have been ready to forgive Anakin about his actions with the Tusken Raiders, he wasn't prepared to forgive Anakin after Mustafar, and that failure was what would partially contribute to Anakin's continued downfall. Therefore, after Luke had shown him the power of faith in Vader's ability to find the light again and his compassion, Obi-Wan too was finally ready to forgive, an important step in the Jedi Master's own evolution. However, Obi-Wan unfortunately also realized that Anakin was dying and wouldn't live for much longer. Recognizing that he knew a way in which to demonstrate his forgiveness and compassion for Anakin, upon his death, Obi-Wan waited for him within the netherworld of the Force, calling out to his consciousness. Anakin would eventually answer Obi-Wan, immediately apologizing for what he had done in choosing the Sith and dark side. But Obi-Wan had already forgave Anakin and chose to share the secret of how to manifest his consciousness as a Force ghost within the corporeal realm. When Anakin asked his former master why he should be given such a gift, Obi-Wan replied that he had proven he was the chosen one and fulfilled the prophecy. but more importantly, in his heart, he knew he wanted to give Anakin the gift of immortality simply because he was his friend, and he had been wrong about him. It's a great scene going well past the simplicity of Obi-Wan merely being stunned by Vader's redemption, showing that Anakin's turn back towards the light also had a profound effect on the Jedi Master, where he was finally able to learn to forgive his former apprentice and remedy some of his own failings as a Jedi. So there we have it, Obi-Wan's reaction when Vader killed Sidious and was redeemed in Episode 6. Thank you very much to all of the Patreon members of Star Wars Reading Club, as your support is so greatly appreciated. You can find all of our social media links and a link to our Star Wars gaming channel in the description below for updates and even more Star Wars content. We love making these videos, so why not subscribe for more fun Star Wars theories and discussions? Also, if you enjoyed the video, think about giving a like or leaving a comment. If not for me, for forgiveness.